Let's return now to one of our top stories, and this weekend is set to be the end of 16 years of Labor government in New South Wales. It could be the biggest swing in Australian electoral history as the state's voters get set to dump Premier Christina Keneally after many scandal-plagued years for Labor. Here's a special report from state political correspondent Josh Murphy.
Bob Carr was the longest-serving Premier of New South Wales, returning the Labor Party to power after 7 years in opposition.
With great humility, I can report to my party today, mission accomplished.
Steering the state for 10 years before his surprise retirement, his highlight, the Sydney Olympics.
The best Olympic Games ever.
It's been a rocky road since he called it quits. The Labor Party's had three premiers in 5.5 years. His first replacement, Morris Yemmer, won the 2007 election, but quickly faced embarrassments.
Today, across city tunnels.
There was Iguana Gate. Senior Minister John Della Bosca and his wife, former Federal MP Belinda Neal, allegedly abused staff in a restaurant. And former Aboriginal Affairs Minister Milton Orkopoulos was also jailed for child sex offences. But his ultimate undoing was when his own team scuttled his plan to privatise the state's electricity sector.
And he becomes a lame duck Premier.
There was a bitter cabinet reshuffle. He resigned in 2008 after losing the support of his faction.
And most of all, I want to thank those who make me what I am, my wonderful kids and my wonderful wife.
The replacement was former Garbo Nathan Rees, who'd served just 18 months in Parliament.
I will be having a red-hot go at fixing the problems in New South Wales.
During his tenure, another John Della Bosca scandal emerged, with lurid details of the Health Minister and Premier wannabe having sex in his office during an affair with a 26-year-old.
I wanted to tell people what he's really like, and I would really hate my state to have a Premier like that.
And his new police minister, Matt Brown, was forced to resign after dancing in his underwear and simulating sex at a post-budget party.
So once I found out that there was this incident where he removed his clothing to that extent, I'm sorry, that's just not on.
He'll also be remembered for the disastrous plans to build a metro rail line to Sydney's inner west. It was eventually cancelled, but the planning stages cost more than $400 million. The party machine dumped Rees after just a year in the role. Installed as Premier, the minister who oversaw World Youth Day, American-born, Ohio-raised Christina Keneally, after she thrashed him in a secret ballot. Rees called the state's first female Premier a puppet of the party's right, but she threw this infamous line back.
I am nobody's puppet. I am nobody's protege. I am nobody's girl.
Her premiership has also endured its problems, including the resignation of former Transport Minister David Campbell after he was filmed leaving a gay bathhouse.
I apologise to the community and I accept responsibility for the situation that I've put my family and myself in.
And MP Karen Palazzano quit in disgrace for lying to the corruption watchdog. Keneally's overseen a virtual party collapse, with half of her ministers and MPs announcing their retirement, grabbing their pensions, rather than facing certain defeat in most cases. And the result could be brutal. The government is being ranked by pollsters as the most unpopular in polling history. But despite the expected rout, she's turned up to every election campaign event, fresh-faced and positive. Labor is likely to lose previously safe seats like Balmain in the inner city. Incumbent and Education Minister Verity Firth hasn't been helped by her husband. He was arrested for buying ecstasy on the eve of the campaign.
Matthew, both to me and to the police, has admitted that he made a terrible mistake.
The polls are pointing to a decisive victory for Liberal leader Barry O'Farrell, best known for his 50-kilogram weight loss to shore up his leadership chances. He's run a safe campaign with few major or exciting promises.
It's time to start the change, real change, to make New South Wales number one again.
He's promised to fast-track rail development, increase spending on hospitals, and has denied plans to cut public service jobs. It seems tomorrow will be an historic moment for New South Wales. Voters unhappy with a 16-year government are likely to bury it. Indeed, many may have made up their minds long ago. Josh Murphy, 10 News.